Jay Haynes for the Film Sensei YouTube channel. Today in this video, I'm going to talk about the new Super Glow effect in HitFilm Pro 2021.2. Super Glow adds an effect similar to Glow, but with more ways to control individual aspects of the effect, and with a more natural and nuanced result. Super Glow has many features that allow you to dial in the exact look that you're going for with regards to each individual shot in your project. In the past, I have personally used what I call the triple glow technique, where I layer multiple glow effects on top of each other to get a natural, full-bodied glow in my shots. With the Super Glow effect, I have found that it is much easier to get a beautiful glow when I need one, and usually with only one Super Glow effect added. Let's take a look. In the main controls, the radius slider adjusts the overall size of the glow effect. The power slider adjusts the glow intensity. The exposure slider adjusts the brightness of the glow element using an exposure value. The spread slider shifts the midpoint of the gradient to alter the size of the hotspot at the core of the glow itself. Increasing this value will give the hotspot more body. The threshold slider adjusts the brightness threshold on which the effect is based. What that means is, like in the regular glow effect, only pixels with a value above the threshold you set will generate a glow. In addition, the threshold smooth slider softens the selection around the threshold value, so choosing a higher value will feather the edges of the selection, allowing for a more natural look. I've found that working with this slider allows me to remove any hard edges that previously would have required the triple glow technique. The clamp to edge checkbox affects how the glow behaves when intersecting with the edge of the layer. Enabling this option ensures the effect behaves consistently right up to the edge. You should almost always leave this enabled. In addition to the basic glow settings, there are additional drop-down menus that further enhance the style of your glow settings. Under the Style drop-down menu, the Tint slider allows you to select a color to blend into the glow effect. You can use the eyedropper to choose a color from the viewer, or you can manually choose any color you prefer. By using the Tint Amount slider, you can control how much of the tint color is blended into the final glow result. By default, the glow color is taken from the layer to which it is applied. But increasing the tint amount shifts that color towards the tint color that you have selected. The Aspect X and Aspect Y sliders adjust the horizontal and vertical size of the glow respectively. The Blend mode controls how the blur is blended onto the clip. Screen Blend mode provides a more subtle result, while Add Blend mode creates a more intense glow. I personally use the Screen Blend mode in darker shots like this, and I use the Add Blend mode in brighter shots. The Hotspots control settings allow you to alter the appearance of the glow in the brightest areas of the image. You have control over these aspects on either the horizontal axis, the vertical axis, or both. Just like they sound, the Size slider adjusts the size of the hotspots. The Softness slider adjusts the relative softness of the hotspots. The Power Threshold and Threshold Smooth sliders mirror the ones above, but within the specific axis. Chromatic aberration is an offset of the color channels within an image, which sometimes occurs due to imperfections in camera optics, and which presents itself as colored fringing around the edges within a frame. This often will happen to a different degree on your glows within your shot than on the rest of the shot. Enabling this feature can help you add a more organic realism to the glow results by introducing these imperfections into the effect. The Distance slider adjusts the offset of the chromatic aberration, controlling the size of the color fringe. The Strength slider adjusts the intensity of the chromatic aberration. The Angle slider adjusts the angle at which the chromatic aberration is offset from the original source image. The channels allow you to select which color channels are offset to create the chromatic aberration itself. I usually stick with the default red and blue. The last group of settings involves adding grain to your glows. Adding grain to the glow can help it blend more naturally with your footage by introducing subtle imperfections and variations within the glow itself, which would not necessarily be in the rest of the image. You can adjust the size and strength, intensity, of the grain. You can also enable the monochrome checkbox, which essentially removes all color from the grain, making it black and white. Also, you can randomize the grain pattern by changing the seed value. I'm Jay Haynes with the Film Sensei YouTube channel, and this has been a close look at the Super Glow effect in HitFilm Pro. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below. I would be delighted to answer them for you. Also, if you enjoyed this video, please do me a favor and leave a like and feel free to subscribe to my channel for more content like this. Don't forget to click the little bell icon for notifications. New videos come out weekly. Until next time, thanks for watching.